We're going to warm you up at the very least with a fantastic dish. We have Terry Ragasa. He's the owner of Sutter Meats in Northampton. We're going to make porchetta, right?
Porchetta, potato, potato.
Delicious. Yep. That's what's the important part. Absolutely. So we start with a pork shoulder. And I think a lot of people, myself included, if you go to the store and you see these huge cuts of meat, people get intimidated.
They do.
So we're going to make it easy today. But so you go home, you go to the grocer, and you get a pork shoulder.
Get a pork shoulder. This is actually be the top of the shoulder. It's called the pork butt.
Okay.
It's divided into two parts. So you have the pork butt, you have the picnic on the bottom. Either one would work. You could also use a fresh ham, which would be the hind leg of the pig. Use all kinds of cuts. Anything that has a lot of meat to it that you're going to be able to butterfly, open up in the season. So.
And you could, if you wanted to, you could ask your butcher to butterfly it for you.
Yeah, you should. If you don't have sharp knives at home, you know, I'd recommend asking your butcher to do it for you.
Okay. Yeah. So butterflying in and of itself, though, we've just cut it in half?
Basically, we're opening it like a book. But before we do that, we're going to score the skin here so that when we cook it, it's going to be able to crisp up. And it's going to be like a nice like porky popcorn in the, on the outside.
Very nice. Yeah. So I see here the skin, and then I imagine this is a layer of fat.
Layer of fat, yep.
Which is where all the goodness comes from.
All the good stuff there. So yeah, you need a cut that has some good fat on it for this recipe.
And it's gonna, a lot of it's gonna drain down anyway.
It's gonna drain out, yeah. You don't want it to dry out, so having this fat to keep it basting throughout the cooking process is key.
So now we score it.
Score it.
This is easy enough. And I imagine if you had a nice enough butcher, he might be able to do this for you too.
You do, yeah.
But I mean, that, what's the fun in that? So you cut into this nicely, and now are we gonna do crisscross?
We're gonna do crisscross, yeah.
In the meantime, what we're also gonna do is we're going to be putting a rub on this, right?
We are, yeah. We're doing a mix of some fresh herbs, garlic, salt, fennel.
And much like we're roasting a turkey, this is something that's going to sit in the oven for a while, is that right?
It is, yeah. Something that's as large like this that has some connective tissue and some fat needs some time to break down in the oven. So this is going to be about a four-hour cook.
Oh, great. Yeah. All right, so now we open it up.
We're going to open it up.
And I see you have a knife holster.
I do.
Ideally, we'd all have knife holsters, but...
Yeah, my dream of being a pirate as a child is coming true.
Congratulations. Yeah. So we cut it in half.
Let me go through this natural seam here where the shoulder blade used to be. Mm-hmm. Open that up.
And I mean, this is one of the things you teach classes too, so people are really interested. They can come on down, but... Oh, wow, that looks so intriguing.
So open that up like a little book.
Okay, I'm just going to push it this way so we can see it on our overhead camera.
Now I'm just going to score this again inside, not too deeply, just and so that the... seasonings can penetrate in all
And it's also because we have a thick cut of meat, too.
Exactly.
Now, the seasoning begins.
The seasoning. So I have this mortar and pestle here. I have some garlic in here.
Mm-hmm.
About just a head of garlic. I'm going to mix in some olive oil.
Okay. I see, yeah, a lot of good spices here. But this is a lot of the stuff, when I was looking at the recipe earlier this morning, I realized this is stuff most people have in their pantries currently.
Yes.
So really, all you're missing from this recipe at home might be the pork shoulder, right. But...
So just a little bit of sage, about a bunch of sage, a bunch of fresh rosemary chopped, and just pound this together to make it a little paste.
And now the paste, we're going to take and rub it up, right?
Yeah, we're going to rub it on there.
Is there a wrong way to do it?
No, it's all going to be tasty. You know, and this is something, it's rustic. You know, it doesn't have to be like a fine cooking here.
No,
it's
exactly.
A nice rough paste.
Sounds good to me.
There you go.
I love this mortar pestle thing.
Yeah, I think it's great.
Now, you salt first?
Salt first. A little blanket of salt on the meat.
And don't be shy with the salt, it seems like.
No. We have a lot of meat to cover here.
That's true. And the salt, like the fat, it's all going to drip off.
It is.
Is there a specific reason that you need to salt it so much?
Salt's good for flavor, you know?
Yeah.
Salt and fat.
It brings out the good flavors, right?
Yeah. Then a little bit of fennel seed.
Okay. And we're not putting this into the mortar pestle because it's already pretty ground up.
It's already ground up, yeah. You can find that at your grocery store, too. A little bit of black pepper.
And I imagine, too, if people are, hesitant with the spices, there's probably spice rubs that come complete with a lot of this stuff. But
sure, you can
if you make your own, you can personalize it in your own way.
Exactly.
Now, a lot of red pepper flakes.
Red pepper flakes. And then we're going to go and get messy here with the
All right, now,
paste.
I have to go over and talk to the Green Thumb Guru in a bit. So do you mind if I tap out on this
one?
Sure, yeah. All right, so I'll wait a little bit. You can... feel free to get it dirty, and then we tie it up. Is that right?
Tie it up.
You know what? Yeah, you only live once.
So let's
get.
All right.
So just go to town.
There's massage it in there. Yeah, it's getting messy.
And now the hard part, seemingly for me at least, to tie it up. How do we do that?
Okay. Get it out of the way. So I was gonna roll this back up here. keep the fat up top.
Because we're going to cook fat up top.
Fat top, yeah, so it's going to keep it basting as it cooks.
Okay.
So we're going to go in with our twine, do a little loop, once, twice, tighten that.
Okay, now roughly how many of the ties do we want to do?
I do about, let's see, one in the middle and then two on each side there, just to keep it pretty even all the way through.
Now, Terry, we're going to put it in the oven after that. At what temperature and for how long?
We're going to put it in a preheated oven, 325 for about, say about 3-4 hours until it gets to an internal temperature of 180 degrees. And then we're going to crank it up to about 455 just to get a nice crispy skin on top.
So you want to finish it up on broil or something like that?
Yeah, finish it high. Yeah, get nice and dry and finish it high.
We're going to leave you to it. I'm going to try to dry my hands off. You know, I'm going to pop over here. And we'll finish up with you in a little bit. How's that?
Excellent. Sounds good.
We're going to head on over to the kitchen. We're going to finish cooking our porchetta with Terry. He's the owner of Sutter Meats in Northampton. That's our oven right there, and we're about ready to pull it out.
Yeah, take it out. It's
now,
good, right?
It's as if we're fast-forwarding 4 hours, so why don't we head on back over here? Joe, you want to grab it?
Yeah.
Wow.
My trusty gloves here.
Ooh. Whoa. Well, that looks like a loaf of bread almost.
Yeah.
So here we have it. It's finished. Now, if you missed it earlier in the show, it's a pork butt or shoulder, right?
This is a pork butt, the top of the pork shoulder.
And
same thing.
We butterflied it, and then we put a whole lot of herbs and spices in it, and actually over there, that's the one that we started out with. Now you want to cut into it?
Let's do it.
All right, here we go. I'm sorry, you're the man who has the knife sheath, so you're better qualified than I to do this.
Let's go right through the center here.
Okay. Now, how would one serve this? Maybe a couple rounds per person with a side dish?
Yeah, one or two per person.
And now how are you going to know when it's done? Because I imagine this isn't easy like a steak or a piece of chicken to know when it's done cooking.
Well, the thing is, different from a steak is a steak you're cooking to like a medium rare or well. This, you're cooking it to a temperature and then letting it sit at a temperature for a certain amount of time to break down the muscle fibers there. So 180 is a good temperature to start with.
So you can throw in a meat thermometer or something like that.
Meat thermometer is the way to go.
So 180 degrees, that's how you do it.
Yep.
Thank you so much for stopping by today.
Great to
Always
be here.
A pleasure chatting with you.
Thank you.